Good day, class. Welcome to the third session of Financing a New Venture. In this session, we will briefly cover how to compile personal income, expenditure, assets, and liability statements. For this session, I highly recommend that you go over your learner guide so that you can have a better look on what we will cover. I will just cover the theoretic side of the session, so you will need to look at the spreadsheets in your own time to ensure that you are able to do all the calculations on your own. It is an attention demanding session because you need to familiarize yourself with the terminology and also the methods of calculating so that you are more comfortable with calculating your own statements. Income and expenditure statements are reports of the money you made and the money you spent during a given time period. Income is the money that is made within the time period of the statement. It is important to account for the income within the period of the financial statement correctly, which includes the goods you sell before receiving the money, even if the customers pay you after the end of the period. Expenditure is the cost incurred within the time period of the statement. Similar to income, you need to include an expense even if you have not paid for it, so that the statement is accurate with the real expenditure that incurred within the period. After calculating both your statements, if your expenditure exceeds your income, then you make a loss, whereas if your income exceeds your profit, then you are making a profit. The purpose of the income and expenditure statements is to clarify how much money was made and spent within a given time period. These financial statements help base realistic businesses and economic decisions. There are legislation requirements that need to be met when doing the financial statement of a company, which states that financial statements should be drawn up in accordance with general accepted accounting practice. A balance sheet is a document that reflects the financial position of a company at a point in time. Unlike the income and expenditure statements, which focuses on a period of time, the balance sheet focuses on a specific date. Companies are required to produce balance sheets every year with the annual financial statements. There are two common terms we need to pay attention to in a balance sheet, which are assets and liabilities. Assets are things owned by the business and are categorized as fixed assets and current assets. Fixed assets are used in the production of income, such as equipment, office furniture, tools, or software on the computers. Fixed assets normally last for more than 3 months and depreciate in value over time. Current assets are short-term collectibles and can be liquidated within the period of 3 months or less, such as debtors, cash in bank, and fixed deposits. Current assets last less than 3 months and they do not depreciate in value. Liabilities are debits that the company owes. It may be in a form of an overdraft to the bank, creditors due for payment, or other loans that were taken by the company. Liabilities are divided into two categories, long-term liabilities and current liabilities. Long-term liabilities consist of debits that a company acquired which have to be paid off in periods longer than the current year, such as a bond or mortgage loan on property that the company purchased. Current liabilities are short-term liabilities that are expected to be repaid within a 3-month period, such as creditors, bank overdrafts, and short-term loans. We have come to the end of our session. Please remember that this session was a very practical session, so I recommend that you go over your learner guide in order to familiarize yourself with the terminology and formula needed for calculating financial statements. Let's take a break before continuing with the rest of the unit standard.